Canada Works has provided two more workers to replace JC for your benefit.
Ontario Works?
Our Ontario Works, sorry. For your benefit. Okay, you're gonna deal with those people and those people alone.
If further information comes forward and I feel that there's potential for charges, then I will continue with it, with this investigation and lay the appropriate charge. But for the time being, you're not charged today. You're walking out the front door just like you came in. My word given to you. Thank you. But if you're going to continue to investigate, can I provide you at least with a recording to balance? Sure, you absolutely can leave a copy here at detachment. I'd love to hear it.
Okay.
Because she did present certain facts, and if your audio proves otherwise, then that's great.
And that's what
to consider.
That's what I was hoping to do.
I've given you the opportunity to present your side. So
yes. And it's fully recorded and presented, and I thank you very much for that chance.
It is, and a copy can be disclosed. You just have to apply for it, and a copy can be provided to you.
The only reason I would have four copies to defend myself in court. So if it goes to court, I'm sure I'll get a copy. But thank you for making me aware of that.
Well, we're hoping it doesn't go that far, right?
Exactly.
We're hoping that there was no threats made.
I have no intention to involve JC in any legal dealings. I think very highly of this, of her.
But you understand that further communication isn't a threat, it's harassment, because she's now requested that that stops.
I understand.
So and there's no communication, because the next communication is a harassment charge.
I understand. So can we assist me also to prevent putting other people into a similar situation by telling me exactly what I need to do in order to get the two psychiatrists arrested and the situation with Georgian College rectified so that I can receive my unemployment insurance through Canada Services?
It's a personal information, private information that you file before a justice. Or you filed.
I tried that on 8th of July. That's why I was.
Have you ever filed your complaint with the local police service to that area?
I stood in the.
Where are the psychiatric?
It was in Barrie. I stood in the Ontario in the Barrie police station on the 7th of October at about 6 p.m.
So
with a document to try and press charges against those two psychiatrists in 2012. In 2012.
So am I right by saying you also have two legal civil suits against these doctors as well as Barrie City Police? Do you have two active civil suits against them?
Not
that you've filed?
Barrie.
Not the police.
The two psychiatrists, yes. Separate suits, but those are not the only suits I've got.
I know.
It's not the people that I'm after. I use the people as advertising vehicles. It's the structures, the non-physical structures. The only real tie that they have are the people. And so you mention the people's names and someone else comes and covers for them and then figures it all out. I mean, the judge
it's up to you to present your information to the City of Barrie, the justice of the City of Barrie, privately. And if you're denied, you can try presenting it to the City of Barrie Police. It's not an OPP matter, but due to jurisdiction.
I presented the information on the 8th of July. He was very kind. He said he can swear the information, but the Crown retains character of the charge and they will more than likely drop it because it's against two psychiatrists and I'm...
Just like a police officer. Just us. We have to have grounds to lay a charge.
Yes.
Obviously, the Crown didn't feel you had enough grounds to proceed with charges. Just because you don't like psychiatrists or just because something happened between you and psychiatrists that you felt was wrong or they didn't give you enough care, that's not criminal. That's your belief, right?
Are we entitled to our own beliefs?
Absolutely.
I was injected.
And that's not criminal.
I was injected so that they would change mine.
Well, see, that's something you have to prove, right?
I'm trying to, but nobody's allowing me to do that.
Well, I don't know what grounds you presented to the Crown. Obviously, it wasn't enough.
I have a recording from Chala threatening me with several threats. I have psychiatrists on three different hearing records. I've got them making false statements about me intentionally. I've got them openly committing perjury on top of the threats, and then I've got Chala committing the offense of bribery, Section 120.
Have you hired a private investigator?
I don't have any money.
Okay. So, from our standpoint, and sometimes the police. Yeah, unless it's urgent to stand by with the interview. Unless you have appropriate grounds. Okay, well then that's urgent. Then the Crowns won't entertain the deal. And they won't entertain ours either if we don't have Crowns.
I understand.
Okay, I have to go. So good luck to you. This officer's given you lots of good advice that you hopefully will take heed to.
Yes.
And
I will not
go through the property.
Have any communication with JC?
Absolutely. Okay?
Yeah.
Good luck.
Thank you.
PD? PD?
I got a VSA.
Okay. I'll provide you the recording.
Bring the recording to the council.
It's on an MP3 a handheld. I had it on me when I was arrested in 2013 before the 16 months. My stuff has been put into storage. Do you guys have any spare cables that I can connect it to my computer?
Not that I know of. So in the next few days, you've got the weekend, put it together, bring it in on Monday sometime. I work Friday night, Saturday night, and I'm back in on Thursday day shift next week.
Okay.
So I'm probably going to pop into the office on Tuesday.
Do you have a card?
I do. I'll give you a card on the way out.
Yeah.
I'll more than likely be here Tuesday at some point to follow up on a few things on my own time. But
the only thing the recording would show is that the conversation with JC was polite, it was non-threatening, but it was certainly serious. We were both acknowledging that it needed to be escalated, and if one listens, one can actually hear that JC was being removed from the circumstances.
And that's fine.
So
just bring it in. I'll listen to it. Understand your caution. If you communicate with her again, you'll be charged with harassment, and you may be charged with threats. Okay? I need to see her statement. And like I said, it's a 360-degree interview here and investigation. So
can you please also accept the other 18 pages because they do kind of tie in?
You can submit to me anything you want.
Okay.
I'll take a look.
Okay.
Within reason.
Yep.
Okay? I don't need citations from...
No, it will only be the 18 pages. And maybe a one page or half a page just explaining about the threat, kind of a recap of the video.
The video will speak for itself.
Oh, okay.
I don't need you to recap it.
Okay. Then
you have a genius mind, and I'm not questioning your mind.
It's
you are scattered all over the place, my friend. You gotta get it together.
I have a beautiful wife.
When does she leave to go back to Taiwan?
We're actually hoping that she's...
You have procedures in place to keep her here legally?
Yes, well, it's always just comes down to a signature, right? Somebody's decision. So we are looking into the formal application process.
Are those her children down there?
It is my son. It's not with her, but.
Okay.
Yeah, his mom is remarried in Taiwan. So Lindsay Sanjay, I'm the moment.
Okay, well, I wish you the best of luck. I'm going to conclude this interview. Just remain in here for a moment. I'll grab my stuff.
Okay.
No, I'll call you from the door over here, okay?
Yep.
Thank you.